sweet surrender.
The hook. This is the hook, man.
Yeah,
right. Let's do it.
Let me see.
I give my heart in sweet surrender. My love.
Burgers and salads.
What's fish and chips?
My love.
Fried fish. Better than fried with french fries.
So Angela, tell me, what did you think of the concert?
I thought it was excellent. Just free, interesting, new musicians I've not heard before or not seen before. All rounder. Unusual to see a drummer who can sing.
Which was the best bit for you?
The little bit at the end, when I don't know, before he sang yesterday, he did this little song on his own, and then the rest
kind
of the band came out.
Kind of a cappella, just with
yeah,
the drums.
Yeah, and I can't remember what it's called, but very soft, very gentle.
Brilliant. Thanks very much. Dawn, legend of this parish, Dawn Payne, what did you think of the show?
Amazing. I'm actually quite overwhelmed. I thought I was going to cry at one point. I've not seen a gig like that in Manchester for years. In fact, across the country, and I go to a lot of gigs.
Just sends tingles down the spine, even now, thinking about it.
I think it's the way that he plays. I've never seen... He joked about being like a black Phil Collins, and I have never seen somebody of his caliber musicianship on stage. And the band were tight. I mean, really watertight, but... You know, a sign of a good gig for me, I close my eyes and I'm nodding and I'm just lost in it. And I was completely lost in that.
Who would you equate him to?
Oh, no one. He's unique. I've not seen anyone like him and I've seen a lot of gigs. I wouldn't equate him to anyone.
John, thank you. Cheers.
Daily, I evaluate myself. I take a journey of how I feel. My emotions control me. Emotions take over me. Possibilities are endless to a life can really be. Take control of my dreams so they can become my reality. Then I can be free. Be free.
Absolutely delighted to have the man himself, Jamison Ross, here at the Band on the Wall. What did you make of tonight's gig?
Man, it's my first night in the UK as a leader. And it was really fun. We had a night off last night, and so I think tonight was a fresh kind of night of music for us. And it's a little different crowd, to be honest with you, because it was the people were very attentive, you know. And sometimes you play in a show and it can be kind of like energizing, but people were like almost listening intently. Like it was almost a dead pin drop of silence you can hear. And so that pushes us to play to a different kind of level, you know. And so every night is different on tour, but this was definitely the first night of our first European tour. First night that we felt like everybody was intensely like paying attention to everything that we were doing, from the notes that we were playing to what I was singing, the solos, the compositions, the words, the lyrics. I love that, you know.
Tell me a little bit about your history, please.
Oh, man. Well, you know, I'm a church kid. I grew up in my grandfather's church. My grandfather was a Pentecostal preacher and a pastor. And my mom thought it saw fit for me to legitimize myself as a musician. She sent me to arts programs at a very young age. I started developing myself as a jazz musician. I fell in love with jazz around middle school, around 13 or 14. From there, I kept playing jazz. And you got to think, I'm a church kid who grew up playing organ, singing, bass, filling in wherever you need to fill in at the same time in the daytime, going to school, learning about Miles Davis, you know what I'm saying, Philly Joe Jones, Billy Higgins.
And how do you come to be a drummer and a singer?
Well, to be honest with you, the drumming is part, most people know me for playing drums. I've toured for a while as a drummer. But the concept of me singing and playing drums was me really trying to figure out a way to introduce who I am as an artist. Everything I do is about singing. The way I play the drums, I like to sing through the drums. When I write music, it's about singing. The thing is, this singing gift I've always had from being a little kid. And so I said, when I got a chance to record a record, my first record, how could I record it without singing? Because it's a part of who I am, you know?
Now, my favorite track on the album is the one, and I won't get the name right, so I'll let you tell me, the one you said that you hid away in the middle of the album.
Yeah.
And yet that's the one that's taken off.
These Things You Are to Me. It's very, man, people love that. I was shocked, to be honest with you, because I did. I put it in the middle of the album just because it's a concept tune. It's a tune that kind of, to me, expressed, it's a lyrical tune, kind of an R&B soul kind of vibe to it, you know. But then if you listen to the song that happens after that, or before that, My One and Only Love, that's kind of a standard that's rearranged into a kind of soul R&B vibe as well. And so I love that tune. The lyrics of it to me is like, you know, the most amazing part. That's why I re-sung it in the session, you know. That bridge, the eyes that glow in the night, sparkle like diamonds, reflecting like gold. You know, that part right there to me just illuminates, you know, those words and the imagery in that writing. So.
Summer rain, quieter than the stream, brilliant as the sun, these things you are to me. They sparkle like diamonds, reflecting like gold. Your nature's precious gift to my dreams. These things you are, these things you are to me. Smoother than the wind, blowing through the trees, fresh as morning air, these things you are to me. these things you are to me. Precious gift to my dreams. These things you are,
things you are,
these things you are to me.
I tell you, your singing has sent tingles down the spine tonight. When you did the Ray Charles song, that was just heavenly, man. Heavenly.
Wow, man. That's, man, I'm a very huge fan of, the thing is, I love jazz, but I also love soul. I love the blues. I love funk. I'm a fan of the pipeline of music that happened from the beginning of time, from traditional jazz through the swing era, through the cool era, you know, the bebop, hard bop, the whole pipeline, funk, the whole pipe, I love it all. And so for me, you can't, Ray Charles, for me as a singing drummer, he's who I recognize or identify with the most, because he was able to sing gospel, country, jazz, R&B. He took the church thing and made it in the club. I love that, man. And that's, to be honest with you, he exemplified that pipeline of music that's so important, you know? And
you won a major award, the Thelonious Monk Award.
Mm-hmm.
The new album, nominated for a Grammy. All of this on one album.
Oh, man, I was shocked about that. I mean, the Drum Award, that's how I got the album, the Thelonious Monk International Jazz Competition. It was based on only drums. Nobody even knew I could sing at that point. And then when I did the album and I just put my heart into it, writing, arrangements, etc., got the right band together, my friends, we played the record, and I had no clue. And I don't think even the label had a clue. Nobody had a clue the record would take off like that. But man, when the record hit, it was a shock to everyone. And then when it got the Grammy nomination, it just was like, I was so thankful to get that kind of recognition on a high level for something that really was coming from my heart. The record is called Jamison for a reason, because it's like the beginning of what I'm trying to do, you know? I'm trying to incorporate these two things and really tell stories through the music as well as through what I'm doing. The drumming and the singing. So it's the conceptual musical part, and then it's the conceptual message, you know, between the two, you know, the songs, the feeling, you know, the invigorating sound of the church meets the invigorating swing of jazz and soul and funk. You know, that's all that's about for me in general, you know.
Over here, over the last couple of years, Gregory Porter has taken the world apart.
Ooh, yeah.
Absolutely blown everybody out of the water in this country. How would you feel being vocally thought of in the same in the same sphere?
Ooh, to be honest with you, man, I can say I'm thankful, but man, Gregory is an amazing vocalist. And all I can say is I'm just doing what's in my heart and singing from the bottom of my heart. And I don't have the training of a jazz vocalist or a vocalist that has, you know, I don't call myself a jazz vocalist. That's not what I do. But I just sing from the bottom of my heart, and I'm thankful for those accolades. But, you know, I'm kind of also a little bit shy and flattered by it, too, because Gregory is amazing. That voice is like, and that's the first thing I saw from the review from the United Kingdom was like Gregory Porter. I was like, whoa.
The new
like,
Gregory Porter.
Yeah, the new, like, I'm like, whoa, are you serious, you know? And even the people, when I signed with my booking agency in the States, that's the first thing they said. It was like, man, Gregory Porter. I'm like, Gregory Porter. I'm like, ooh, that's kind of scary. Because you gotta think I'm a drummer, too, at heart, you know? And so for me, I'm a musician. And so for me, it's all about the musical experience. I'm not necessarily keying in only on the voice or only on the drums. It's about a whole entire concept.
Let me tell you this. One of the things I enjoyed most is normally you come to a gig and the drums are too loud. The drums are too loud. Tonight, the drums were the perfect volume at the perfect time. And that's because you were in charge of the drums as well as the vocals.
Wow, man. I mean, honestly, that's what it's all about. I have a lot of secrets and a lot of tunes that I want to unveil down the line, more music, new music that'll come out. And, you know, really, you know, when I talk about the research of the singing drummer, I've really checked this stuff out, and I've really done my research of all the drummers who sung on a large level. Most of them get up from the drums, and they eventually don't play drums anymore. I'm not trying to do that. I'm trying to stay behind the drums, but I'm trying to show that concept to be something special, you know, bring people inside of the musical part as well as just the feeling. Okay, you can feel good from me singing this tune, but you can also learn something and be very uplifted mentally by watching it. You see what I'm saying? Like, there's a deeper level to it, too, which is the jazz side of the modern-day jazz side, shall we say, of people being invigorated mentally through jazz and through the lineage of the music and the understanding of it. Take that and put that with the soul of the singing, and then you draw people in. You know, you bring people into what you're trying to do. Next thing you know, everybody, you walk away overwhelmed, educated, uplifted, freed. Whatever you know, everything. You're happy because you come to a good show. That's what music should be.
You know? Well, let me tell you, the thing for me tonight that made it just joyous was your enjoyment being on stage. Every step of the way, the smiles on your face, the excitement on your face, it was just beautiful. And it's been a pleasure being here tonight. I wish you all the very best for the future, and I hope that somewhere down the line we get to speak in our studios, and look forward to that.
I would love to. Seriously, you reach out to me, they'll tell you. I'll talk anytime. I'll come up in the morning, get up, come to the station. I'm an open book, you know. So
it's been a real pleasure. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Many blessings.
I've got a dream for the world. Peace in the rivers and everywhere. Bridges of steel and love, cities that smile. Gray empty faces walk by, and hands try to hide all the loneliness, lighting a cigarette to blow time away. Lost in the noise, lonely as a wind. People on sidewalks with no place to go. Can they learn to understand the world of love that I'm dreaming. I said I've got a sack full of dreams, streets full of laughter and toy balloons, people with hearts that care, yeah, who listen for love, wanting the same, wanting to care, wanting to share all of my dreams for the world. Can they learn to understand the world of love that I'm dreaming, 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 dreaming? to care, wanting to share my dreams for the world. Can they learn to understand the world of love that I'm dreaming? The world of love that I'm dreaming.